had bought the ranch, and he'd bought the horses and the trucks, and he'd ridden the horses all day long, and he had a sore butt. He called George Klein, George's fiancée at the time worked at the medical group, and said, you know, Elvis needs to be seen. So she took a poll in the office. Dr. Nick said, well, I'll go see him, but I'll have to go after hours. And he did. And then, I don't know, a month or so after that, Elvis had another issue and called Dr. Nick. And Dr. Nick says, you know, I did you a favor before, but said, I'm in a practice of 12 other doctors, and you'll have to become an established patient. So we shut the clinic down after hours, of course, and brought him in, and I was taking care of him. And he was sitting in a chair in the corner talking to me, but he was looking down at his knees. And I just walked over to him, took him by his chin, pulled his chin up, and I said, Elvis, if you talk to me, you look at me. Brave soul. So I went ahead about my business, and I started to the lab, and I got a page to go to Dr. Nicopolis's office. And I thought, well, I'm probably going to get fired over that. So I knocked on his door, and I said, you call me, sir? And he said, yeah, what did you say to Elvis? And I thought, well, that doesn't sound good. And so I told him, he said, he liked you. So that's the way it all began. But we were pulled apart because her mom did not agree. And I had two daughters, and of course he had Lisa. We lived out in East Memphis, so I'd bring them down to Graceland to play with her. And though he kept on till he moved us to Graceland. We moved to Graceland in 72, and we lived there in a trailer in the backyard until 83. Marie is only 6 years old. Information, please. Try to put me through to her in Memphis, Tennessee. So I was an Elvis fan from like the 56 on. So I was very, very blessed to have a nurse-patient relationship and have a friend relationship with somebody as iconic as Elvis Presley. Well, it's hard to be a gambler betting on the number that changes every time. He didn't make a big deal out of his birthday. He didn't like a notoriety. He didn't like a lot of notoriety called to himself, period. But he surely didn't on his birthday. And then after he got up in the 30s, he, you know, it's just going to be another day. We just got celebrated Christmas, so I have to tell you, I was always a candy maker. And of course, at Graceland, we didn't lock anything, and Elvis would walk in the trailer like your brother or something, and I was making some chocolate peanut butter candy and dipping it in chocolate. So I'm doing the peanut butter candy, and he comes in, you know, what you're doing, da-da-da. So I said, I'm making the candy. So he gets him a spoon, he takes a bite of the peanut butter. And he said, I think it needs a little bit more peanut butter. So he takes another spoonful and he says, I believe it needs a little bit more sugar. So we did this for 6 or 7 times. And finally I said, look, you're going to keep eating the peanut butter. I'm not going to have anything to dip in chocolate. But that's just, you know, I mean, it wasn't, oh my God, Elvis Presley's in the kitchen. I mean, it was like family. And I was very, very blessed with that.